Here's the professor of preventive dentistry at one of our British universities.
Could you tell us about the studies that you've been carrying out?
Certainly. For the last 9 years, I have been examining the teeth of children in 2 towns. In 1 town, fluoride has been put into the water, and in the other town, none.
What differences have you noted in the children's teeth?
The differences are tremendous. In the town where there's fluoride in the water, the teeth are healthier, they're stronger, they have a much better appearance, so much so that even an ordinary person could distinguish children from one town from those in the other.
People say it's only effective for young children's teeth. Do you think this is so?
No, this is a popular fallacy. But the benefits of fluoride during the period of tooth development are carried with the individual throughout the rest of his life.
What about this other old bogey about all the ghastly diseases you're going to get? Is it absolutely safe?
Perfectly safe. I think our best guarantee of safety is the fact that about 500,000 people in this country live in areas where the water has fluoride in it, very often in excess of the amount that we require for perfect dental health. And the only difference that you find in these people is they have far better teeth.
Now, this is where there's fluoride in the water naturally. Is the effect the same in areas where it's been artificially added?
Exactly the same.
Would you say that the medical and the dental profession recommend this idea?
Yes, both the medical and dental profession thoroughly support this idea.
Well, thank you very much indeed.
The Minister of Health, with all the weight of evidence before him, has approved that fluoride should be introduced into our drinking water. But even so, the final decision rests with your local authority, and they can only put approval into practice with your support.